the top five beauty tips that cost almost nothing. Do you think that the best kept beauty secrets lie in fancy, expensive moisturizers or creams that cost hundreds, even thousands of dollars? Wrong. You see, your skin is like a puzzle, and the best kept secrets are the missing pieces that complete the picture. These elusive fragments, much like the secrets, don't come with a price tag. They are actually free, you see, and they effortlessly slot into your skincare routine, forming that glowing image without requiring any payment for their contribution. I cover many, many inexpensive options for you on this channel. Like and subscribe if you're getting value. Let's pop in. Not only are most of these free, but you probably already have everything you need to do them at home. While I'm a big fan of treatments and investing in skincare that works, you don't have to break the bank every time to get glowing skin that helps you walk through the world with confidence. Key. Now, many of these tips are ones I've learned from my incredible patients. You see, when I see someone walk in with that extra bit of radiance, I'm always, always curious about what gives them their skin glow. So I ask. These are the top five tips I've collected over the years. My first tip takes us back to ancient China, Gua Sha. While this one isn't exactly free, you only need to buy the tool once and you can use it for years and years. This technique involves using a smooth edge tool, usually made from a stone like a jade or a metal, to gently massage the face, promoting circulation and lymphatic drainage. Now, Gua Sha isn't just for your face. Traditional Chinese medicine or TCM practitioners, they've been using this treatment for centuries to reduce inflammation and improve circulation. That promotes healing through the body and for us in our skin. You see, according to TCM principles, the energy or qi in your body must be able to flow for you to feel your best. They believe that many health issues arise when this energy becomes stagnant. In fact, researchers at the Korea Institute of Oriental Medicine and Department of Internal Medicine in Essen, Germany, they studied and found Gua Sha to be effective in treating musculoskeletal pain and chronic neck pain. Now, what does this have to do with your beauty routine? Well, you see, using Gua Sha and this tool with a gentle face oil will help reduce puffiness, inflammation, and brighten your complexion. It can even shape your facial muscles along with exercises. You see, you hold a lot of tension often in your face. And what I like most is the lymphatics. They play a huge role in, think about your malar fat pads. You all ask me about that, and people struggle with that. That's the pad, not just below the eye, not the eye bag, but on the cheek here. And then, of course, you have eye bags and jowls. Now, how do you know lymphatics play a role here? Because they can wax and wane. You know this. You know that some mornings you wake up, you have eye bags, others you don't. Later in the day, you don't have it. Often that's lymphatics and blood flow, and that's where Gua Sha, I think, really shines. Number two, facial steaming. This isn't one I thought I'd be telling you about, but I did buy a few steamers over the last few years to test them. If your skin is looking drab, facial steaming is one of the easiest ways to transform it in just a few minutes. It's quick. Take a quick scroll through TikTok, Instagram, and you'll see all these varying steaming devices like I did. Are these convenient? Well, absolutely. Are they necessary? Not at all. Did I buy these few to test them? Of course, I was intrigued too. I fell into it, went down the rabbit hole. Most of them are about $20 to $50. The one I found worked best was only $24. All you really need to harness the power of facial steaming, if you don't want to buy one of these, is some hot water, a towel, and a few minutes. Start by bringing water to a boil on the stove or electric kettle. Place the water in a heat-resistant bowl. Place the towel over your head and the bowl and enjoy your little spa moment. It helps to set a timer from anywhere for 5 to 15 minutes is really enough. Research has shown that facial steaming will help enhance circulation and it loosens the buildup in your pores. You'll see them actually come to the surface, some of the sebum and the blackheads. Just don't start picking them. It's very tempting. Facial steaming will even help increase the absorption of your skincare products. That extra heat, the moisture, the blood flow. So a lot of people tend to do this at night. Will it get rid of your face fat? Often I'm asked. No, it's not hot enough. For face fat, think 40 to 45 degrees Celsius for about 15 to 20 minutes. We don't get to those levels. My one caveat is to avoid facial steaming if you do have melasma and eczema. Both of those can be aggravated if you do have them. Number three, oil blading. I did a short on this the other day, but you know those people that seem to have no pores, they have that glass skin, they have the dolphin baby skin. A lot of them are doing this. Now you've probably tried all the serums and moisturizers, but you may be missing this one key step. Oil blading is one of the most amazing yet effective ways to gently, key is gently, exfoliate your skin. This helps give you that dolphin skin. It's a look that not everyone wants the full dolphin. You can calm it down to the glass skin, I suppose, but you get my idea and the point here. It works particularly well if your makeup tends to get cakey by the end of the day, or you have extra rough patches or peach fuzz. You have to try oil blading if you have these, but it's also called oil planing. So if you're looking for it and you can't find it, you might find it under that. And no, your hair will not grow back thicker. If you have existing hair, you might feel some stubble. People don't like that. They won't do it. But it won't make it in and of itself grow back thicker. If it's growing back thicker, you think about hormone problems or irregularities or other problems, genetic reasons for your hair, but not the microblading. They're confounding variables, not causative factors. So how do you do this? Start with cleansed skin, then apply your favorite face oil. I like light ones for this, so think sunflower seed oil or your favorite light oil. That helps protect the skin from irritation. You then gently shave your face in a downward motion using a special facial razor. What you don't want to do, you don't use the same one you use on your other parts of your body or legs. You get certainly inexpensive items to do this with on Amazon, Target, wherever you tend to shop, you'll find them. One common misconception is that oil blading is the same as dermaplaning. While they're pretty similar, yes, dermaplaning is done on dry skin using feather-like movements. Oil planing is easier to do and generally safer. You want to skip this one if you've recently had a chemical peel or sunburn or have irritated, inflamed, acne-formed skin. Tip number four, facial massage. I had a patient walk into my office a few months ago and I immediately thought, wow, she has some of the most vibrant skin I've ever seen. Was it for me and my services? I would have liked to have thought so, but I hadn't seen her in a while. Her secret, I asked, facial massage. We all love a good massage, of course, but facial massage is not just about relaxation. It's a powerful way to sculpt and tone your facial muscles. Much like gua sha, but you use your hands instead. Facial massage helps to increase circulation, reduce tension, promote collagen production. You also get a change in hormones. Think testosterone, serotonin, and so on. The relaxation part. Of course, prolactin, oxytocin. So look into my adaptogens and study homeostasis, but massage helps with those. Think of it like a workout for your face. I posted a short clip a couple weeks ago and the person was tapping on their face. Many of you had comments about that. But just how effective is facial massage? Well, researchers at the International University of Health and Welfare in Tokyo, Japan, I was just there, found that participants who practiced daily facial massage showed measurable differences in their cheeks and facial structure. That amazed me. And it wasn't professionals doing the massage either. These results were obtained from the participants doing facial massaging themselves. So this is an at-home treatment. That means you can do it too. This technique has also been found to help improve facial sagging, a common question you all ask me. It helps lift and tighten your facial muscles. There is a way to do it and way not to do it, so be mindful. Next is facial ice bath. Now, it may sound chilly, but the benefits are worth it. Cold plunging is all the rage right now. You see it all over social media and in the wellness world. Not only can it be hard to get a tub big enough to practice this plunging in, but not everyone wants to fully submerge themselves. I did videos on cold plunging and many of you told me that. You don't want to be in the ice cold water. If you're using a shower to plunge, in effect, I recommend placing a timer in your shower and building up slowly. Some of you don't even want to do that. But if you still want to reap the benefits of cold therapy, if you can't plunge or cold shower, simply take a bowl big enough to fit your face in, fill it with water and ice, and submerge your face in the bowl for about 10 seconds at home. You can try a little longer if you can comfortably hold your breath up to 30 seconds or so. While there aren't any specific studies on facial ice baths, we can look at anecdotal evidence and studies on cold plunging to see how impactful this can be for your skin, your hormone balance, and your face. You see, studies suggest that exposing your skin to cold temperatures can constrict your blood vessels, reducing inflammation and puffiness. It's like a wake-up call for your skin, leaving you looking refreshed and revitalized. Facial ice baths even reduce redness and tenderness for rosacea breakouts. It's not just your skin that benefits from a facial ice bath. Many people report that a quick 20-second face dunk helps reduce feelings of anxiety and fatigue. It's like hitting the reset button for your mind. I love incorporating facial ice baths into my routine, especially on days when my skin feels like it needs a little pick-me-up or my mind is racing and I need a little reset. Just 20 seconds on my skin, I find it looks better, it's refreshed, I kind of wake up and you're ready to roll again. You really should try it. Now, I want to hear from you. What is your top free? You get one, only one for the comments. You can add more, but give me your one top beauty tip that's inexpensive. Drop your answer below in the comments, but you're now going to want to watch this video playlist on the benefits of red light therapy and one down here on adaptogens that help balance your hormones, anxiety, and manage your sleep. So important for your skin. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.